So welcome to the video series of biomolecules. In this video we are going to talk about proteins. So basically, what is the proteins actually? In this video tutorial we are going to talk about all the things regarding the protein, right? So the protein is the polymers of amino acids. Now what do we mean by polymer of amino acids? So the basic unit of protein, that is the amino acids. This amino acid attach together and the form bonds and they make the sequence of amino acid, right? Now this is the polymerization events. This polymerization of amino acid and forms the peptides. So this polymer of amino acids, that is called proteins. These proteins will be formation in the cell, and that functions are differ based on their amino acids as well as the different environmental conditions. So this formation of proteins on the ribosomes, right, by the ribosome. These peptide bonds are formed by the ribosomes. These bonds are formed, that is the CONH bonds. Now these amino acids that makes the sequence, and that by this bonding they are going to be attached there and makes the proteins. Now before we are going to talk about this classification of proteins, let us understand about what is the amino acids and how they are making the peptide bonds and they are going to be attached and makes the protein sequence. So that is the amino acid sequence. So this is the structure of amino acids, right? That is the structure of amino acid. So in this structure of amino acid, there is the different groups are going to be attached there. So these groups are the amino groups, carboxyl groups, hydrogen atoms and the R groups. These all are groups attached to the central carbon atom. So that is called alpha carbon, right? Different groups are attached to this carbon, central carbon. So that is called alpha carbon, and this forms the alpha amino acid. Right? Now, based on the different R groups, the amino acid are differ in their structural characteristic. This is the general structure of amino acid. So there is, based on the different R groups, suppose the simplest amino acid, that is glycine, that contains the only hydrogen group instead of R, right? So that is called glycine. If the hydrogen attached instead of these R groups, right, that is called glycine. If the CH3 is going to be attached, the amino acid will be alanine. If this OH groups is attached, that is serine group, that is serine amino acid. So the amino acid are differ with their R groups. Now how the proteins are going to be formed, how they are going to be attached with the different amino acids, right? Now this amino acid also can be classified into different ways based on their R groups. Suppose an R group contains the non-polar. R groups are non-polars, so that is called non-polar amino acid. If this R groups are polar, if the R groups are aromatic, right, that they are from the different amino acid. If the R groups are contains the positively charged groups, if the R groups contains the negatively charged groups. So the amino acid can be classified in this way. You can see in my different videos how amino acid can be classified. The links is given below the video and also in the cards. So the now how the amino acid are going to be attached and they form the proteins, right? If I talk about, that is the right. So this is the way by the protein can be formed. So that is the one amino acid and that is the second amino acid, right? Now what happens in this carboxyl group on this terminal, that is the C terminal, right, that is attached to this एन टर्मिनल. सो देर आर द टू टर्मिनल ऑफ एमाइनो एसिड. देर इज द एन टर्मिनल एंड देर इज द सी टर्मिनल, सी डबल ओ एच ग्रुप्स एंड द एन एमाइनो ग्रुप्स. नाउ द वन ऑफ द सी टर्मिनल इज अटैच टू दिस हाइड्रोजन एंड फॉर इट इट रिलीज द वॉटर एंड मेक्स द सी ओ एन एच बॉन्ड. सो दिस इज द वन एमाइनो एसिड एंड दिस इज द सेकंड एमाइनो एसिड. बिटवीन द एमाइनो एसिड देर इज सी टर्मिनल, एट द सी टर्मिनल ऑफ वन एमाइनो एसिड एंड द एन टर्मिनल ऑफ अनदर एमाइनो एसिड दे आर फॉर्म्स द बॉन्ड्स एंड मेक द सी ओ एन एच बॉन्डिंग एंड दैट इज द एमाइड बॉन्ड. Now the amino acid is going to be attached and release the water. If there is protein is going to be broken down. Now this free C double O groups for this one end and there is amino groups are react to this another amino acid. In it makes the sequence of amino acid and it makes the protein. Now if there is hydrolysis of proteins, right, there is the hydrolysis and this and there is addition of H2O and there is the removal of H2O, right, there is the two things. If H2O is removed, there is CONH bond is formed. Now if there is addition of H2O, right, it broken down into the amino acid. This protein will broken down in the amino acid. Now this peptide bond forming are on the ribosome of cell organ, that is the cell organ, right. This formation of peptide bond on the ribosome, by the ribosome. And suppose if there is broken down of proteins, there is the addition of H2O and this that is bind with this group and makes the different amino acid. So there is the broken down of amino acid and there is the broken down of proteins and there is the formation of amino acid. So that is the building blocks of protein. Now if I have to write the sequence of amino acids, so I have to write from this N terminal to this C terminal of protein sequence. So there is the amino acid sequence I have to write from the N terminal to C terminal. There are the different ways to write the sequence of amino acid. So if I have to give the name of peptide, so there is the method or pattern to write the naming of peptide. So one of the method that is the three letter codon. Now amino acid have a different letters. Suppose serine amino, one of the amino acid that is serine. So it can be written as S-E-R. So that is the three letter codon. There is three letter codon different for each amino acid. So if I have to write from this N terminal, right, serine, glycine, alanine, leucine and whatever the another amino acid are going to be attached to this side. So I can write also this way and I can also write the one letter code. So that is the differ for each amino acid. Suppose there is the serine, if I have to write the serine, right, there is the one letter code for serine, that is the S. So S for glycine, that is G, for alanine, that is the A, and for the leucine, that is the L. So there is the method for writing the peptide, that is the one letter code, and you can also write from this three letter code, right. Now if I have to classify the protein, how I can classify? So there are the different ways for the classification of protein. Now one of the ways, that is the structural classification, that is the structural classification of protein. So I have to scroll down, right. So that is the structural classification of protein. Based on their structure, there are the four groups for that structures. Now protein can be also classified based on their solubility also. lithium. Based on their chemical properties, so one of the classification that is based on their structure. So the first one, that is the primary structure. So this primary structure that contains the linear sequence of amino acid, so that is called the primary structure. Now the second, that is the secondary structure. So in this secondary structure, there are the spirally coiled structures are there. That is called alpha helix and the beta sheet structure. And the third one, that is the tertiary structure. Now in this tertiary structure, it refers to the arrangement of secondary structure into this three-dimensional structure. This arrangement of secondary structure into three dimension, right, that is called tertiary structure, and it is going to be folded in structure, that folds, that is the folded structure. Now the fourth one, that is the quaternary structure. If this polypeptide are going to be attached and makes the one more than one polypeptides, if the polypeptides are associated to each other, there is the association of polypeptide and makes the quaternary structure like that way. Different polypeptides are attached and make the quaternary structure, so that is called the quaternary structure. So there are these four ways, based on their structure it can be protein can be classified. I hope this video is helpful to you guys. That is all about the protein, basic things about protein. If you want to go detail, you can check out my other videos in my channel. So I hope it is helpful to you guys, and thanks for watching. I hope that is helpful to you.